nowadays I see that the world is much more aware than in the past. I think that is an important aspect. I also see the people of the academy being much more aware. At the beginning, I was shocked to hear that some of us were thinking that climate change was bullshit. Now, everybody is convinced that is a very, very important thing. We have launched the new paradigm, and also the new paradigm in education, where we think that it's not true having competition with the somebody asked me at the bar this afternoon, is how you're going to compete with all the important, well-financed, research and think tanks. And I answered that, probably for my character, the person thought that I was kidding, we don't. And I think we are wise enough to do, because we are intentionally different. For us, the process is the product. It's important not to be blind to that. And so, we didn't come away, I certainly not, with the recipe. But would that have been a failure if we did? And I think there is a lot of virtue on being humble and facilitate the communication with respect of every idea among not only ourselves, but hopefully with larger and larger group of people, institutions. And so I, in my opinion, as nowadays everybody is well aware of the limits of thinking naively, oh, there is always been progress, the more the better. And naively, oh, we're going to export democracy, you know, and maybe use some bombs to be more convincing. That nowadays we all slowly realize that democracy is a process. It's not granted. You cannot subscribe and somebody grants you democracy every year, like Time Magazine. But I embody in the relationship with myself, others, the world, and not just human beings. Yes. You know, so it's a political decision how I treat plants and animals, not just human beings. That's also relative how I treat myself, how I relate to myself and my different needs and aspirations. So I think that we are all more and more aware that we need maintenance for democracy. That's what I read. And that also we need urgently, I agree with the urgent, to create a process where we co-create effective tools to manage the rippling and increasingly rapid, change. That it cannot be stopped, and so it can be only navigated or be floundered. And I think it's important that we keep humble so we can learn from everybody and also empower everybody. And finishing, somebody coming here and listening and seeing the curriculum of everybody, people say, oh, nonsense, you're not qualified. On the mechanistic, reductionistic, point of view, might be that person would be right. But we are not a traditional academy. We are not a traditional world university consortium, nor listening to you, we are traditional people. So maybe it's true that instead of saying it, we can learn it something, although somebody that says it is, not even a PhD yet. I really like the 1 minute movie that you show us. Not that I think that is the perfect recipe, but that energized me, and I feel keen to those people, those things. And I have done that, you know, the student revolution. And one of the limitations was that we wanted to convince everybody that we had the perfect solution. People that have perfect solution, history taught us, have been really doing big damage. So let's watch out not to have a perfect solution for the world. It could be a nightmare. Yeah. So thanks for everything.